Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. In today's video, we will see how to interface a passive buzzer module with the STM32. We will write functions to set the tone of the desired frequency, and in the end we will play a melody. There are two types of buzzer modules available for interfacing. An active buzzer is only capable of producing a single tone. So to interface an active buzzer, you just need to turn the signal on or off, just how you would blink a LED. On the other hand, a passive buzzer needs a triggered wave to produce sound. By controlling the frequency and duty of the wave, we can control the sound output. In today's tutorial, we will cover how to do this using the STM32 MCU. Here I have two different types of passive buzzer modules with me. Both of these modules have three pins available, but the middle pin in this module is not connected. So we only have a signal pin, and a ground pin. It does not need a separate VCC supply. We can connect the PWM output to this signal pin, and then vary the frequency and duty to control the output sound. The other module has all three pins connected. You can connect the VCC to 5 volts, ground to ground, and PWM output to the I/O pin. Both of these modules are available on the Controllers Tech store, so you can purchase them from there. I am going to use the black one in this tutorial, as it needs only 2 pins for the connection. This is how the buzzer is connected to the STM32. The pin PA8 of the MCU is the timer 1 PWM output pin, and it is connected to the signal pin. Let's start the Cube IDE and create a new project. I am using STM32F103C8. Give some name to the project and click Finish. Let's start with the clock setup first. I am selecting the external crystal to provide the clock. The Blupil board has 8 MHz crystal on it, and we will run the system at 60 MHz. I am choosing 60 because most of the STM32 MCUs can run at this clock frequency, so if you have some confusion, you can set the clock as per this video. Note that both APB1 and 2 timer clocks are running at 60 MHz. The timer will use this clock to generate the output signal. Each timer is either connected to APB1 or APB2 bus. You can check the datasheet of your MCU to confirm which bus it is connected to. I have already made a video explaining the PWM generation in STM32, you can check it out in case of any doubt. Since both the APB timer clocks are at the same frequency, I don't need to worry about the timer's source. Now go to Sys, Debug, and enable Serial Wire. Let's configure the timer now. I am using the timer 1 to generate the PWM signal. Set the clock source to internal clock. Now enable the PWM generation for channel 1. You can see the pin PA8 got configured as the PWM output. We connected this pin to the buzzer in the connection diagram. Let's configure the parameters now. In order to generate the sound of desired frequency, we need to change the prescaler on the fly, but keep the ARR constant. The timer clock is at 60 MHz. Let's say if I keep the auto reload value constant at 1000. Now if I want to generate a frequency of 15 kHz, the prescaler should be set to 4. Similarly, if we want to generate the frequency of 250 Hz, the prescaler should be set to 240. We will write a formula in the main code to calculate the prescaler for desired frequency. So let's leave the prescaler to 0 for now, and set the auto reload value to 1000. We will not modify the duty cycle throughout this video, rather we will keep it at 50%. So set the pulse value to half of the auto reload value, so the duty can be 50%. That is all the configuration we need. Click Save to generate the project. Let's start with a simple test first. In the main function, we will start the timer in the PWM mode. The parameters of this function are the timer handler and the timer channel which you have selected in the CubeMX. In the Cube MX configuration, we set the prescaler to 0, so the timer will run at 60 kHz. So before starting the timer, we will set the prescaler to 240. This will generate a frequency of 250 Hz. Actually, this value should be 239. Whenever you are setting the prescaler, the value should be one lower than the desired value. This is because the code at the register level adds a 1 to this value. I will fix this in the final code, and also mention it in the article. Alright, the code has been flashed successfully, and now you can hear the sound produced by the buzzer. Now if I set the prescaler to 24, the frequency will be 2500 Hz. Let's test this frequency. You can clearly hear the sound with a higher pitch than before. Let's change these frequencies in the while loop, so that we can hear the differences between them. You can hear the tone changing every 500 milliseconds. Let's also see the output on the second buzzer. We pretty much got the same tones in this buzzer also. A note is produced by managing these frequencies and their timings. We will also do the same, and try to produce a random melody. We need a function to calculate the prescaler value for the desired frequency. Let's first define the timer frequency. You can change it as per your setup. The argument of the function prescaler for frequency is the desired frequency which you want to output. Inside this function we will use the same formula which we have used so far to calculate the prescaler. The return the calculated value. In case the frequency is 0, we don't want to pass the value to the formula, so we will simply return 0. Now inside the while loop, I am generating the output at different frequencies. There is a delay of 250 milliseconds between each tone. Let's build and flash the code to our board. You can hear the tones of 5 different frequencies, and the pitch is gradually increasing. And in a way we just produced a note of these tones. Basically you can produce any melody by mixing different frequencies and their duration for which they will play. While I was looking for some frequency data for a melody, I found this GitHub repository. This is actually written for the Arduino, but we are only interested in the frequency and timing data. Here this guy has also explained how to generate the data for any desired music, but it is a paid service, so I am not covering that. Inside the Arduino code, I found the data for the Stranger Things melody. Any melody will contain these two data at minimum, the frequency, and the timing. Let's copy them in our code. These here are the frequency values for different tones, and below are their duration in milliseconds for which these tones will play. There is one more parameter which is used in the Arduino while playing these melodies. And that is the delay after the tone, for which the tone is paused. We will also consider this delay in our code. Let's write a function which will play the melody for us. The parameters of this function are, the pointer to the frequency array, the pointer to the timing array, pointer to the pause timing array, and the size of these arrays. Here for each array element, we will calculate the prescaler value for the input frequency. Then get the duration for which the tone will play. Now define a variable to store the pause data. If the pause array is passed to the parameter, we will get the pause timing. As per the Arduino source code, this pause timing also considers the duration time, so we will need to subtract it. Now let's set the prescaler value as calculated above, and give a delay of the duration time. But if we do want to pause the tone after this duration, we will not play any tone after this time, and it will continue to pause for the pause time calculated above. We will define this noTone function. Inside this function we will set the prescaler to 0. This will actually generate the output frequency of 60 kHz, which we can't hear, so it will be treated as the pause. Let's call this function in the main function, and pass the parameters. There is no pause data here, so pass the null here. Also, we need to calculate the size of the array. After the melody is over, we will call the noTone function to stop the tone. Alright, let's flash the code to the board. You can hear the Stranger Things melody being played by the buzzer. To demonstrate the use of the pause, let's set the pause time of 30 milliseconds after each tone. You can clearly hear the pause between the tones here. This is it for the video. So we were able to interface the passive buzzer module with the STM32. We produced the sound of desired frequencies, and also played a melody successfully. You can try some other melodies and let me know the outcome. The link to download the code is in the description below. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.